I mean, what's some of the other myths of organic chemistry?
That's one of the big ones.
that it's useless? That you'll never use it again?
I think that one of the most valuable things, there is a question, is the knowledge of organic chemistry, is understanding biology at a molecular level actually going to be useful for the majority of our students? For some, I have no doubt that it will be, but for most, probably not. But probably the most important thing that they will obtain out of organic chemistry, it's a course of ideas. And problem solving is that the problems we have in organic chemistry aren't terribly difficult, but you get the experience of working these very complicated, problems that are more complicated than you might not normally encounter. And so I think that's one of the that's probably the number one most important thing you get out of organic chemistry is problem solving. True, you got to know stuff, and some of that stuff might be useful to you.
It doesn't hurt to be an educated consumer or be able to read the label on your, you know, shampoo bottle or whatever you're going to use.
The lectures are just full of the New York Times from the previous day.
Knowing whether you're buying a generic drug is the same as your $50, $60 name brand drug.
Some of the students, I think, really get into the material itself. I think one thing about organic is it really takes, the students are taking all these different science courses. They're from physics to chemistry to biology, biochemistry. And in organic is one of the places I think they really see how to put it all together. Mm-hmm. I mean, like one of their favorite topics this last semester was when we were talking about some of these biosynthetic pathways, which is the way nature makes these complicated molecules. And so you could talk about making a steroid, and you know, all the students have heard about steroids. They don't know what they are, but they've heard about steroids. And so these are really complicated molecules. So how does nature put these things together? And so you have a cation. And they know about cations and charges from physics, it's electrostatics. And so how do you take that cation and actually, some enzyme, but it's still the cation, folds this thing up, makes these chemical bonds, and you come up with this very complex molecule. And the amazing thing is you understand the steps. Or at least you think you understand the steps.
It's the appreciation that you can, either nature or you can synthesize and make things, whether you make molecules, make materials, make your LCD screens or your OLED screens, and make things that might save somebody someday from a strep infection.
My students really like the synthesis aspect of it. This is one of my favorite parts. So I'm into this. I gave them a problem every day on synthesis, on the website. Basically every midnight a new problem came up, and the best students in the class just thought this was great. I mean, they were having so much fun with this. We had this competition develop at midnight as who could post the correct answer first. And these were complicated answers because there are free software packages available where they can draw out their chemical structures. They still take time. I mean, there's minutes to draw these things out. So they not only were they solving this complicated synthesis, which might have 10 steps, they were drawing it all out and then running to see who could get it up on the web first. So I would have things come up at 12, 11 a.m. And then a couple of students, the other students thought they were cheating because they were drawing it out by hand and using their cell phones to take a picture of their solution and posting it. This wasn't fair. They weren't drawing it out properly. But of course it was fair.
So now are all the students sitting in their dorm rooms doing this? Or are they hanging out somewhere?
Well, sometimes some of them are doing it together. I mean, and there were, I mean, these problems came up every day. I mean, I had a couple weekends where I had problems up on, Saturday morning at 1 a.m., and they were at the party, and they were doing these things. I mean, this is, James is sitting there writing, says, I haven't got my ChemDraw program. I'm doing this by text at the party. this is a little bit crazy. But it tells you that the passion that kind of develops with this. And there's this sense of competition. It's very friendly competition, because I was also very impressed about on this web-based problem solving is, you know, the students would criticize each other's work.
Oh, they
would
give critiques.
Oh, yeah, this is one of these. It's like a forum. It's a discussion group. And so one student would post something up, and somebody else would say, well, I like your synthesis, but I don't think your step number three is going to work. And sometimes they would know how to fix it, and other times they wouldn't, but they just knew it didn't work. So it was a lot of fun. And I think that's what's really developed during the whole term. And I would say everybody. I mean, you have 1,000 kids, but
and I think that's the same atmosphere that I every time I've gone down to the Chemistry Learning Center, especially before an exam. It's the same sort of people helping each other and going up to the board and no, that's not how you do it. You do it this way. But that's a really important piece of the course is there's a physical, there's the web where they can exchange, but there's a physical area where they come together and can discuss it. And maybe somebody doesn't have a group of friends like you're describing. They can show up at the Learning Center and find some people who are working on the same problems or who have already worked it.
Oh, the key thing is participation.
And get some help there. And so it's sort of a, how many hours a week is the Learning Center open? 40, 60
years. Well, yeah, it's almost
continuous. Well, the door is never locked.
The door is never locked. There might or might not be TAs in there.
So if you could sneak your way into the building, you can go to the Learning Center, and they do. So it's a fun place.
Because you're allowed to make noise. It's not like the library where it's individual study space.
Well, this is the big difference, I think, in organic chemistry compared to the way we used to teach it years ago. It's this student-oriented. The students really do a tremendous amount of education on their own. And you see that in the workshops, you see that in the Learning Center, you see it in class, is that you can ask the same question twice. You put it up.
Right, just, nobody gets it.
If it's sort of a tie.
Right.
And then you say, well, talk to each other again and try and convince the other person that you're right and they can convince you that they're right. And see if it changes. And oftentimes it does change, and it goes in the right direction. Sometimes
it doesn't.
And I have no explanation. I've learned so much about students using those clickers.
You can see what their heads are really doing.
You can see what they're doing.
Why Bill's, did they, Bill's lectures are so clear, and sometimes they still don't get it.
No, but you do. You try to plant the seed of the information in a couple of places in the room so that, that it can spread
it
virally, you know, through the crowd.
And of course, the feedback is still good for us because sometimes we really do think they understand, and they don't. And we learn as well. You know, they don't really, you know how to apply electronegativity in this instance.
No, there's no way a group of 600 people could put in their clicker responses and get exactly 50-50 on two different answers on purpose.
That's right. Although sometimes I think they're teasing us.
Well, to sum up, I think what we're all trying to say is that participation of the students in the course is absolutely essential. This is the way you will succeed at organic chemistry. Organic chemistry is not difficult, but you must work at it, and you must work at it every day, and working at it with other students makes it far more enjoyable. Well, thank you, Joe.
Thanks, Bill.
Thank you, Nicole.
Thanks, Bill. It's been fun.
Okay.